Om Namah Shivaya students, welcome to English language online classes of class 7. Today we are going to learn about noun number and noun gender. So now what is noun number? That means which refer to one or many. That means which denotes how many person, thing or animals are there, and that is denoted by noun number. If it is one, then it is singular, and if it is more than one, then it is plural. So a noun that denotes one person or thing is said to be in singular, and a noun which denotes more than one person or thing is said to be in the plural. For example, tree, book, book, animal, father. Next, trees, animals, books, mothers. So since in the first case they are referring to one, so they are said to be in singular number, and in the next case, since they are referring to more than one, they are said to be in the plural form. Now how we form the plural of the singular nouns? First is by adding s. So boy, boys, table, tables. Next is by adding es to the noun which ends in s, sh, ch or x. For example, brunch, branches, latch, latches, box, boxes. Next is by adding es to nouns ending in o. Plural noun may be formed by adding es to the nouns. For example, tomato, tomatoes, tornado, tornadoes. Next is by adding s to nouns ending in o. So in this case also the noun ending only s is added. For example, photo, photos, logo, logos, piano, pianos. Now you have to keep in mind that in these cases, when the words are ending with o, es or s both can be added. In some cases es is added, and in some cases s is added to make the plural form. Next is by changing fe or f to ves. Okay, so that means we are completely changing it. Okay, so over here in the first example, half, we are changing F into VES. Next example, knife, we are changing FE to VES, knives. Okay, okay, next, by nouns ending in FE or FE in other cases. In other cases, they take either VES or S as their plural forms. For example, both can be possible. Dwarf, it dwarfs, both are possible. You can add s also, you can add ves also. Hoof, hoofs or hooves. So we can say these are exception also, that are not following the general rule. Next, when the nouns are ending with f or fe, the plural form is formed by adding an s only. Chief, chips, handkerchief, handkerchiefs, cleave, cleaves. So only s is added. Next, by changing y to ies, you should remember that when y is changed to ies, then the word should have, that means before the y there should be a consonant. That means y should be preceded by a consonant. But when the y is preceded by a vowel, then only s is added. Okay, just listen carefully. Army, army, armies. So army, m is a consonant which is preceding y, hence ies has been added. But if I say an example, boy, 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 that is also ending in y, but that is preceded by a vowel o, so only s is added in that case. Got it? Okay, next is by changing the inside vowel. Man, main, goose, geese. So A is a vowel that has been changed to E. Again, O are vowels and that has been changed to E. Okay. Next is by adding EN. Plural nouns may be formed from singular nouns by adding EN to the singular. So ox, oxen, child, children. So EN are added to form the plural one. Next is formation of plural nouns by keeping the singular noun unchanged. So singular and plural noun are same in number, no as or es are added. For example, sheep, sheep, deer, deer. So both the words, the one word is also referring to the singular number and the same word is referring to the plural number. There is no need of adding s or es to make it plural. Next is nouns used only in the plural form. These are certain words which are used in the plural forms also. There is no singular form of these words. For example, scissors, spectacles, suspenders, jeans, shorts, thanks. Okay. Next is nouns that look plural but are singular. So, mathematics, billiards, news, they are looking plural, okay, as s is added at the end, but they are actually singular in number. Okay, next, collective nouns used as plurals. There are some collective nouns which do not change their number. For example, poultry, cattle, people, these are collective nouns which do not take a plural form. Plural of compound nouns. The plural of compound nouns is formed by adding s to the principal word or by making the principal word plural in some other way. For example, father-in-law, fathers-in-law, passer-by, passers-by, salesman, salesman. So in that case, we have seen that s or the plural form is made of the principal word, not of the additives. Okay. Next is plurals of words from other languages. These are mainly from Latin language or Italian, where you have to mainly learn. Index, indices, crisis, crisis, bandit, banditti. Okay. So next is nouns with plural forms with different meanings. Now here are certain words which convey a different meaning when they are formed plural. Brother, this is a singular one, but plural is brothers, sons of the same parent, or brethren, fellow members of the society or community. So, which the spellings are different, or you can say the plural forms are different, and they are conveying different meanings also. Another example over here is cloth, cloths. When only s is added, it is meaning the pieces of cloth, or when it is said clothes, that means it is meaning about the garments that one wear. Okay, nouns with two meanings in the singular and one in the plural. So some nouns have two meanings in the singular and only one in the plural. So light, radiance, or a lamp, plural lights, lamps you're talking about. Another is people, men and women, or a nation. People can say about men or women or a nation, people of the country. We are talking about the nation, all of the people, right? Plural, peoples. It is only standing for the nations, that means which is in plural form. Clear, class? Next is nouns with one meaning in the singular and two in the plural. Singular, for example, color, hue. Plural, colors, hues, or the flags of a regiment. It have different meanings. Quarter, fourth part. One quarter, that means fourth part. Plural, quarters, fourth parts, or lodgings. Where do you stay? I stay in a quarters. So there also. And now next is your nouns with different meanings in the singular and plural. Some nouns have different meanings in the singular and the plural. Air, atmosphere, plural, airs, affected manner. So see, their meanings are completely different from one another. Okay, iron, a kind of metal, irons, fetters, or chains, that means that are used to bind something, to fasten up something. Plural, letters and numbers. Plurals may be formed from letters or numbers by adding an apostrophe and an s. So the K's in the document are lightly printed. That means whatever K's, the number of K's in all the letters that are having, the all the K's are meaning by that. Okay? Okay. Next is plurals of abstract nouns. Abstract nouns usually have no plurals. They are consonant uncountable nouns. We have learned that the countable nouns only change their number. Uncountable nouns do not change their number. So, and since abstract noun falls under the category of uncountable nouns, so say they also don't have any plural form. But for example, they may appear in the plural, and in this case they are being used and countable nouns. For example, loves, meaning many things that are loved. That means things. Over here it is meaning to the things that one loves. Next is hopes. It is there also you can count that many things that you are hoped for. I have lot many hopes in my life. That means you have lot many things that you are hoping for. Clear, class? Now with this we came to the end of noun number. Now let's see what is noun gender. Now noun gender means that is either meaning to the male or the female or to both. Now based on that we have four kinds of gender: common gender, neuter gender, masculine gender and feminine gender. Now what is the common gender? The noun that can denote both male and female gender is said to be of a common gender. For example, person, parent, enemy, servant, neighbor. Now all these words are referring, it can be a male one, it can be a female one. So it is said to be in common gender. Next is neuter gender. A noun that denotes a thing that is neither male nor female is said to be a neuter gender. That means mainly the non-living things which don't have life. Leaf, fruit, pencil, paper. So these are counted under the category of neuter gender. Next is your masculine nouns. So noun that denotes a male person or animal is said to be of the masculine gender: boy, king, bull. And a female person or animal is said to be of the feminine gender: girl, queen, cow. Got it? Now we will now see the rules how masculine and feminine are changed in between. So feminine nouns may be formed by using entirely different words from masculine nouns. For example, husband, wife, bull, cow, king, queen. There is no certain rules for these words. You need an entirely different words for forming the feminine gender. Next is by adding a syllable without dropping a vowel, such as ESSINETRIX or A, without dropping the vowel of the masculine gender. For example, author, authoress, poet, poetess, shepherd, shepherdess, hero, heroine, testator, testatrix, czar, czarina. So over here what happened, we haven't dropped the vowel, we have either added ESSINETRIX or A to form the feminine gender. Next is by adding a syllable and dropping a vowel. So over here you will add a syllable also and you will drop the vowel also. So actor, actress, you are dropping the vowel O, then you are doing that. Tiger, tigress. Okay, you have dropped the vowel E. Duke, duchess. Okay, so that's how the feminine genders are made. Next is formation of feminine nouns by placing a word before or after. Now, when it is a compound noun, we mainly change the one word to make the feminine gender. So, over here, grandfather, grandmother. Father is the main word of the compound noun. Landlord, landlady. Salesman, saleswoman. So over here we have changed the gender of the principal noun and hence the feminine gender has been formed. Now apart from all these things, there are different ways in which we may change the gender of the noun from masculine to feminine. One such way is by adding the word she before the noun. For example, she goat, she wolf, which are formed from he goat or he wolf. Now you should go through your Ren and Martin for lot many examples that you over there so that you may solve the exercise that we will follow in the next video. I hope the explanation is clear to you. In the next class we will solve the exercises. Till then, thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.